ದೇಶದ ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಕರ್ತವ್ಯ. ದಿನದಿಂದ ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ಭಾರತ ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಹೊಂದುತ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸರಿಯಾದ ಆಯ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರಿಂದ ಬಂದ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ನೇರ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಿದ ಮಾನ್ಯ ರಕ್ಷಣಾ ಸಚಿವರು ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ಸೀತಾರಾಮನ್. ಇದೇ ಈ ದಿನದ ವಿಶೇಷ ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ರಕ್ಷಣೆಯ ಮಾತು. ನಾನು ಆಶಾ. ಅನೌಪಚಾರಿಕ ಸಂವಾದದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ ರಕ್ಷಣಾ ಸಚಿವರಾದ ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ಸೀತಾರಾಮನ್ ಅವರು ತುಮಕೂರಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ.
I am told that my opening statement will have to be on something to do with New India, the kind of reforms, and also something to do with defense and India's security. That kind of a topic, I'm afraid you can talk for a very long time. And it has so many different aspects to it which will be worth discussing. But clearly today we are talking about all these things at a time when the country is going through the process of electing a new government. So talking about New India and also talking about defense of India in that context all fall within the framework of an electoral year in which the process has already commenced. The first phase is over. But based on what has happened in the last 5 years, the very terminology New India has come into the public discourse purely because of the way in which the Prime Minister has extended a lot of visionary steps to make India completely new from the point of view of how we govern ourselves. We have to govern ourselves with a lot more sense of pride, ownership, sense of understanding where India should be, because each one of us are contributing our own. But however, the collectiveness of all our contribution doesn't get that kind of attraction which a country of our capability, a country of our size, a country of our the skills which our young people have should deserve to get. That is why you see that in the last 5 years, all the effort of our Honorable Prime Minister has been to change the narrative about India, to change the way people looked at India, to change the way people think that nothing can happen in this country, and make them feel, yes, a lot of things can happen in this country which will make you feel proud as Indian citizens. And that is why I think the new India that we are talking about, the initial foundations have been laid in the last 5 years and the results are showing.
ಇನ್ನು ಸಚಿವರು ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರಿಂದ ಬಂದ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಿದ್ರು. ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡೋಣ ಒಂದು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ನ ನಂತರ. ಎನ್ಡಿಎ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಮಾತನಾಡುತ್ತಿರುವ ವಿಷಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಮಾನಿಟೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಉದ್ಯೋಗಾವಕಾಶ. ಇದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ರಕ್ಷಣಾ ಸಚಿವರು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡೋಣ ಬನ್ನಿ. Being formal commerce minister, how would you rate demonetization on a 10-point scale and why?
A 10-point scale, but I will definitely say one or two things about it. It had both short-term and long-term impact on our economy. Short-term impact and long-term impact have definitely, and you would agree, have definitely changed the way in which we look at our economy. We look at how we handle ourselves in the economy, whether as private individuals or as individuals who are doing businesses, and in the way in which we handle our finances. It is necessary that every economic activity, what is an economic activity? Buying and selling, producing, trading, all are economic activity. Every economic activity should have some records somewhere. Money transacted generates value. Money transacted also produces many other ripple effects in the economy. If 80% of all transactions that we were doing before demonetization was only in cash and with no records of transaction at all, can you please recognize the fact that the economy cannot calculate those transactions, cannot take into account those transactions when you are actually evaluating the size and the value of your economy? So once you enter a transaction, either through a bank movement of your money, you put somebody in their account the money that you have to pay them, or you receive money through banks, there is some kind of an accounting of that movement.
So are we strengthening our economy or are we undermining our economy? And therefore demonetization served the large purpose of every one of our monies going into the bank, and if you claim that it was legitimately your money, it was not treated as a black money. If you just put the money all right into your bank but you still didn't have an answer, obviously you have to say where you got that money from. If your explanations added up, fine. If it didn't add up to that extent, you had to pay a penalty and say, now legitimize this money. Today, as a result, and post that, when GST also has come into the works, every one of us benefit from, if we are a producer, the input costs now being able to legitimately get passed on. And you get the input credits for it. And those buyers don't pay twice the tax, one to the fellow who's giving the input and one to the fellow who's giving you the value-added final manufactured commodity. So it saves you additional tax, it saves you from duplication of tax, it also makes sure that producers don't artificially need to jack up their price because the inputs are all costed, tax paid. If that tax is removed from their expenses and they're given credit for it so that they can move it to somebody else, it helps even in effectively costing each one of the small product to big product. So demonetization made the beginning for it, and as a result, today the economy is a lot more accounted for, and we don't keep monies under the bed, under our sofas, and think we are rich. We have made the country poor by doing that. You can be rich and also make the country richer by accounting for it. That's all the demonetization's impact was.
The opposition attacks the government on job crisis issue. How do you respond for job crisis?
With the data, we can respond to with data and meaningful logic. Data about jobs in this country, not after Modi ji's government, but even before, collected by institutions, always confined themselves to collecting data on jobs only in the formal sector. Formal sector is those who are working in government, those who are working in banks, those who are working in companies which have registered trade unions and so on. But I'm sure, even if you walk around Tumkur, you'll know how many such companies or such institutions are existing only in Tumkur. Very few. But does that mean that in Tumkur no other activity happens? Each one of us are engaged somewhere. Smaller jobs are being conducted by many people. There are small enterprises where 3 or 4 people work. These are unorganized sector. There is no way in which any government institutions collect data on them. So as it is, in this country, there has been only institutionalized data collection on jobs through organized sector working, formal sector. What happens to the rest of them? I don't know why enough time and attention was not given, but we don't collect data on them. Now, of course, there's a way in which government is trying to sort that mess out. So what has happened is, when you look at jobs only as 9 to 5, and with employment being not just there, with many employment existing outside, and this is not today's case, it's India has always been like that. We don't have proper data to prove this way or that way. However, I will say from the government, if loans are being given to unorganized sector people through Mudra of all sizes, and people have taken loans, does it mean that they are not working, or does it mean that they are working and maybe for expansion of business where they bring in a few more additional workers? The EPFO, Employees Provident Fund organization, records people who come and contribute for their pension. Their numbers are going up. Who are these people? Old ones have their pension. The new ones also have to come on board. They're coming on board and paying. These are indicators to say that there are, other than formal sectors, jobs being created, jobs being assisted, jobs being facilitated. So a meaningful debate on jobs will have to include all this and not just the confines of the formal sector. In this government, we have given entrepreneurs and enterprises more loans than ever before. So we would appeal to everybody who wants to talk on jobs to talk about that as much as talking about Mudra, as much as talking about banks which are giving for small and medium industries. Take all of them on board.
In 2014, when NDA elected, people were happy that the scheme will be outdone in the last 10 years and they will be behind bars. But this were not done completely. How do you respond for this?
Are layered and it takes its own time. It is only because we are really allowing the law to take its course and not interrupting in them or disrupting them, doing favors to those who have violated the Indian law, that they are moving fast. And because they are moving fast, a lot of defaulters are finding the heat on them and therefore they are leaving the country and running away. We are making sure that they are brought back, and in the meanwhile their assets are confiscated. That is why when you hear Prime Minister who says, look, in the 5 years I have made sure that many of these offenders are on the verge of going into the jail, I need more time to send them into it. So within 5 years you have not done this, you have not arrested them, even when you are not interfering in the process of investigation, but making sure that every black money related, every offender related cases don't suffer from prejudice and that they should go on. We are accused of vendetta. You are accused of doing it for political purposes. If there is pakka information on some black money being hidden somewhere, or some illegal money being kept, or some money being used for some wrong purposes is kept, and if ED or Income Tax Department go there, they are all processes which are happening. And therefore, as Prime Minister rightly said, it is getting closer. They will be in the jail sooner.
Dear Minister, your take on the Nyay scheme announced by the Congress in its manifesto as an economist. Is it economically good for a country like India?
It's a scheme for eradicating poverty, right? It's a scheme for eradicating poverty? Do we understand it like that? No? Is there a different understanding? What is it? Huh? No. Is Nyay for removal of poverty or is it for something else? For removal of poverty? Mike, no, I just want a in-the-face answer. What does Nyay, why was there need for Nyay, or what are they saying that they're going to do with Nyay? To remove poverty or to help the poor.
Not
No, no. You may give your own interpretation, but what the Congress is claiming is that this nyay is for people who are poor. We have to do nyay to them, and therefore I'm bringing it. Right? I am asking, isn't that what Mrs. Indira Gandhi said when she said Garibi Hatao? Isn't that what after that also Rajiv Gandhi, Narasimha Rao time, all Congress's ruling aimed at removal of poverty? You've heard of 20-point program during Mrs. Indira Gandhi's time. First of all, even before they bring the nyay out, they should say we have to bring the nyay because from Indira Gandhi's time we tried but we failed in removing poverty. Let them say that first. And now that they say, yes, we failed in removing poverty, I'm bringing nyay because now we want to execute it better. Then the debate starts whether it can be done. I want to contrast it with many of the schemes that we've done without making a big noise about it. How genuine poor get free gas connection, and how genuine poor get electricity, how genuine poor also has Jan Dhan given to them. All in the last 5 years, if anything, taxes have come down, they've not gone up for any section. Whereas, even as they talk about nyay, the guru of the Congress Party's president, Sam Vetroda ji, has already said, nyay can be implemented, but the tax will have to be increased. And the middle class will have to be right and fair to the society, so they'll have to bear the brunt. My question is, how come they seem to take the middle class for granted that for the decades of failure to remove poverty, it will be the middle class and not the first family of the country to pay the money? You ripped off the country. You pay it.
ಮೋದಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರಧಾನಿಯಾಗಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸಚಿವರು ಏನಿರ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡೋಣ ಒಂದು ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ. ಪುಲ್ವಾಮಾ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಎನ್ಡಿಎ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ವಿಶೇಷತೆಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ಸೀತಾರಾಮನ್ ಅವರು ಏನಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡೋಣ ಬನ್ನಿ. On 7th April 2019, the Chief Minister of Karnataka, H.D. Kumaraswamy, made a statement to the media. The Pulwama will be orchestrated 2 years later, just before the elections to win the elections. This is serious or just a election gimmick? Is it necessity that he should hold his breath before speaking it?
Chief Minister said it. The Chief Minister has said it. I would want to take it very seriously.
The Chief Minister has also told that those who do not have food for 2 times will join the Indian Armed Forces.
I'd like to take it very seriously. And if 2 years ago itself, this unnamed army or Air Force, Armed Forces personnel has wanted that before the election such a thing will happen, I wish he warned us, because the lives of the 40 Pulwama martyrs would have been saved. I wish he had warned us. Now, would it be that he is equally responsible as much as the suicide bomber?
Yes.
I'm asking a question. I'm asking a question. A chief minister got to know that 2 years ago some unnamed armed forces personnel has told him this. I wish in the interest of India and I wish in the interest of the CRPF, who sacrificed 40 of their men, our brethren, he had alerted us. I wonder why he didn't.
In the same bureaucracy and same machinery, how is possible that UPA was not able to achieve that NDA achieved in this 5 years?
Because I think you should be committed and dedicated towards putting the nation first and making the country work. You cannot blame the bureaucracy, or you cannot blame any one section without trying to work with them honestly. There may be one or two exceptions in every field, but I like to say that once you show that you're working honestly, most of the bureaucrats work together with you. They get scared of people who have other agendas, so they may not work, or they may distance themselves, or they may say, no, we don't know what is in this. But with this government, with Modiji's leadership, policy drives, policy works. It is policy which decides, but we don't interfere in it. That is why officials know that if they're working together, all of us are equally committed to doing a transparent job. Nobody is fixing the other person and making others a scapegoat. And therefore, bureaucracy works.
Any defense procurement takes a very long time. Will it continue the same in future, or will be taken short time?
Yes, I think a lot of procurement based on the exigencies, the powers have been delegated to the vice chiefs of the three forces. So if they think they are running short of ammunition, if they're thinking that they are running short of some critical equipments, the powers are well within the vice chief's armed forces headquarters to take a call. So they can go about buying it, nothing delays them, nothing stops them. One. Second, as regards capital procurement, which normally takes a lot of time, we have made the procedures simplified without sacrificing transparency. So when Defense Acquisition Council meetings for capital purchases used to happen once in 6 months, now they're happening once every fortnight.
The communists were being routed from Bengal and recently from Tripura. They have only small pockets left now. Is there any chance of revival at all?
If all of us choose not to vote communists, there will never be a revival. It's us who are giving legitimacy to outdated ideologies, to violent ideologies, to ideologies which doesn't suit the tone, tenor, DNA, culture, ethos of this country. Ideologies which are alien to our culture. We don't need to give them any kind of support. So if you don't give support...
When there are hundreds of reasons to state that may NDA get back to power, what according to you are five big reasons that the NDA will be back in power?
First, the government is led by a decisive, clean leader. Very unlike prime ministers who have been remotely controlled. Here's a prime minister who sits together with his council of ministers and takes a call for what should be done and what should not be. So he's hands-on and directly engages in governing this country. So that I would say is the second. Third, tirelessly works for this country, doesn't take picnics or outings or breaks. You may say that's his style, I don't need to govern the country like this, I'll still take breaks, but govern. You don't disappear even during critical times and come back and tear pieces of legislation which your own government has done. You go on a picnic or come back, and after you come back, even when the Prime Minister is not around, I tear legislations because I got to know about it now, so I have to tear it off. This type of part-time running of this country cannot be accepted. Full-time engagement is what this country of this size, of this population, of the kind of aspirations that we have, we need full-time attention. So, even if you legitimately claim your personal time, When you attend to the country, you give it full time and you don't act whimsically, mercurially, shout out and tear out and call people names. We want somebody who's going to be mature and responsible. And therefore, the Prime Minister. Fourth, doesn't ever forget his humble origins. Even reaching the level of Prime Minister and having been a long time undefeated Chief Minister of Gujarat, his feet are firmly on the ground. He doesn't get carried away. I am the Prime Minister. No. His feet are firmly in the ground. He runs a responsive and a government which is sensitive to the needs of the people. If you think that something is not happening, he responds to it. He engages with people directly. He doesn't depend on a few, you know, interlocutors in the media or somewhere who build him up. No, he talks to you directly. So that's the fourth reason. And the fifth, he's got a vision for India. In 2014, he spoke about 150th anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, which is in 2018-19. And said we need...
ನೋಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರೆ, ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರು ಕೇಳಿದ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ರಕ್ಷಣಾ ಸಚಿವರಾದ ನಿರ್ಮಲಾ ಸೀತಾರಾಮನ್ರವರು ಯಾವುದೂ ಮುಚ್ಚು ಮರೆಯಿಲ್ಲದೆ ನೇರ ಉತ್ತರ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಚುನಾವಣೆ ಹತ್ತಿರದಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಯಾರ ಕಾರ್ಯವೈಖರಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿದು ಮತ ಚಲಾಯಿಸಬೇಕು. ಇದೇ ಈ ದಿನದ ವಿಶೇಷ. ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ವಿಶೇಷ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದೊಂದಿಗೆ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದೆ ಬರ್ತೀನಿ. ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ ಪ್ರಗತಿ ಟಿವಿ. ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮಿಂದ ನಿಮಗಾಗಿ.